interrupt this program with breaking news. Sunday morning, 7th of December, the U.S. Navy and U.S. Army were taken completely by surprise by a Japanese sneak airstrike. The first attack wave targeted military airfields and the battleships at anchor in the harbor. The air raid lasted until 9:45 a.m. 8 U.S. battleships are damaged, 5 of which sunk in the harbor.
Hi, welcome everyone back to Sound Hunter 4 Wolves of the Pacific UBO Missions with the Fall of the Rising Sun Ultimate Edition mod. It's been a while since I played this game last. For those of you who are newer to the channel, or have simply forgotten who I am, I'm CodRaven1728. And I have quite a long history with this game. This is actually the first game I ever recorded for the channel. Over 5 years ago, as of now. And we still haven't actually finished an entire campaign of this game, mainly because of, well, running into bugs and all sorts of other problems. We also had a U-boat campaign we were working on, but we're gonna have to restart that as well. A few minutes ago on stream, I just tested the Japanese submarine mod, but it doesn't look like it plays very nice with Fall of the Rising Sun, as you might expect. It would have been nice to play with it in Fall of the Rising Sun. It's not quite a deal breaker. I heard that you can try with Operation Monsoon. I might try that. But we'll probably be doing a U-boat campaign as well at some point. I don't know if I'll be able to do the U-boat campaign under Fall of the Rising Sun, but we'll see. But for now, it's time to do a fleet boat campaign. And for the boat we're gonna pick, I have a very specific one in mind, so people on the recording are going to see when I actually get the boat. Those of you on the stream will actually get to count how many times it takes for me to roll the boat. When I was testing, I rolled it on the first try. I was doing off-camera testing because I actually thought the mod was broken. It turns out the mod was not actually broken, it was operator error. In the other time I tried to record this, a couple of days ago, I tried to start this series. Sargo class, renown, there is not a selection, and difficulty will fix once we get inside the game. Right, let us begin. Alright, did I roll the boat first try? Yep, I did. SS-196, USS Sea Raven. The very first boat that we got when I first played this game over 5 years ago. Right. We probably won't finish the game in this boat, by the way. We'll probably play the Sea Raven for a few months. Up until probably August 1942 or so, and then I'll take the Gato class if it offers it to me. And although it is tempting to play the Sea Raven through the entirety of the campaign, I might end up doing that. Anyway.
Gentlemen, as you already know, we are at war. I quote the President of the United States. Yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy, the United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan. The attack has effectively eliminated our entire battleship force for the time being. As a consolation, it has failed to catch any of our aircraft carriers in port, while the submarines and fuel reserves have escaped unharmed. During the past years, the Japanese military was engaged in a seemingly endless war against China, badly needing oil and other raw materials. Since we halted the trade with Japan, they schemed to seize the oil and mineral-rich East Indies and Southeast Asia. A Japanese attack into the Indies, Malaya, and the Philippines was expected, and plans prepared for it. But obviously, we have not prepared enough for an attack of this magnitude. The attack against Malaya has materialized yesterday, and last night the Japanese forces also attacked Hong Kong, Guam, the Philippines, and Wake Island. This morning, the Japanese continued with an attack on Midway. The Japanese offensive is extending throughout the Pacific, with a submarine force left mostly to itself. We need to act accordingly. For the time being, we will conduct operations as follows. Boats based in Pearl Harbor will patrol in Japanese home waters and also reconnoiter the Marshall Islands, as it's presumed that Japanese forces are massing in that archipelago for a second attack on our bases. Manila-based boats will deploy to guard the vital island of Luzon against approach by enemy forces. Individual patrol orders will be received from your commander.
All right, December 8th, 1941. Cavite Naval Base, Manila. I believe it's pronounced Cavite. Right. First thing, save the game. Let's get our boat outfitted. Actually, before that, realism settings. That's the save game button. Right, manual targeting, torpedoes on. We'll see if it's too out of control. From what I've seen of other people playing this game with this mod, the dart torpedo rate is not completely out of control, which arguably is not very realistic for the Mark 14 torpedo. Anywho, we actually do have a air search radar. We have a 3-inch, 50 caliber deck gun, Mark 21. Technically a dual-purpose gun. So, it has 25 degrees of elevation. It's not great. Better than some, I guess. It could be better. I'm looking for like 40, 45 degrees elevation at least. Ideally like 70, 90, or even 110. Looking at the Japanese 100mm dual purpose gun there in particular. That one has 110 degrees of elevation. And that's 50 caliber. Which we found out in our other test is not up to the challenge of shooting down enemy aircraft. At least as of right now. I'll probably get better at shooting with it. For those of you who've seen my German playthrough, granted the German U-boats have a lot more flak weapons because it's 1943 instead of 1941, you would know that I've shot down most of my attackers instead of diving away from them. So we don't have a surface search radar. We have an SD radar, the air search radar. It's default to off, which I'm not used to, because in Silent Hunter 4 stock, the stock game, that thing is on, whether you actually have it on or off. For our torpedo, we have, as I mentioned earlier, the Mark 14 torpedo. This is the early Mark 14 torpedo, which at this point in time, I do not believe has had an actual live fire with an actual warhead that actually exploded ever. Mark 14, if I remember correctly, never actually was live fire tested. They tested the motor with a dummy head, which was weighed incorrectly, and was partially of why the depth keeping problems became a thing, specifically at longer ranges. The other thing with the impact head is the pistol that detonates the warhead. So either it be the impact pistol or the magnetic influence pistol. Basically a big rod that pushes down, or that pushes into the head that detonates it. Sits vertically mounted in the Mark 14 as opposed to horizontally mounted. As in, it's mounted up like this. I think it's like right here, actually. It might actually be back here. But the idea is when it receives an impact, it'll release the tension in the spring and gravity will feed the thing down, detonating the torpedo. The problem with it was, they found this out, especially on the faster speed settings, was that the head was simply crushing the piston before the detonator, before it could actually achieve its job of detonating the torpedo. And this was for a variety of different reasons, but that was one problem with the Mark 14. They did eventually get this fixed. Eventually. The Bureau of Ordnance also kind of didn't want to admit there was a problem to begin with. But anywho, we'll have plenty of time to talk about our Mark 14 torpedoes. Right, so we have this gentleman. This is our second in command. He is probably the most important person on the boat besides us because of this ability here. So this is something for the Fall of the Rising Sun mod. Basically, if we lose this guy, we're basically going to lose our ability to run underwater rather quickly because our batteries will have problems charging. Right. Gun crews. So let me arrange... Take him. Yeah, that'll be the deck gun crew. You. You will be a different gun crew. Let's grab all these other guys. Oh, he's got good watchman skills. We'll see if I bother rearranging everyone. These guys don't cost any renown, so they can get on the boat. Might arrange a third gun crew. So that's, if we, for whatever reason, end up losing that guy, we can get a second one there. Alright, I don't think there's an easy way to get a sword like crew. Which among you guys has the best guns? Guns and leadership. Two guns. That's going to be our third gun crew. Why am I stacking so many gun crews? Well, one, I can rotate them if I want on the deck gun. Two, we're going to eventually get more anti-aircraft guns, and I might need them. I don't think I'll need 8 people for my flak gun, but we'll see. I was very tempted to pick the Narwhal, by the way. The Narwhal is special in this mod, and it gets dual 6-inch. That'd be 152mm deck guns. I was very tempted to pick the Narwhal. And we're probably going to play a... We're likely to do an entire campaign as the Narwhal. But if I did that, that would be a Narwhal exclusive. Another thing, Fall the Rising Sun changes. You may notice I don't have a choice of deck gun or anti-aircraft gun. If you remember in the stock game, that would be I would pay the renown to upgrade that to a Twin Orlikan 20mm anti-aircraft gun. And then I would have replaced this with a 4-inch deck gun. And would have been very tempted to throw all of these off my boat for Mark 10s. Tempted. Probably wouldn't have thrown them all off. Right. With that all set, we have everything set. We're going to save the game again, because this is our mission pre-launch. I still haven't learned how to spell sortie, by the way. Alrighty, let's get our assignment. So after 20 minutes, we can actually get going. Alrighty. Camarac Bay, French Indochina. Let's see if it crashes. It might crash. Oh, we're good.
Yes, sir. All stop.
Alrighty, let's get rocking and rolling, shall we?
Sonar, warship, moving away. Bearing 151. Long range.
Right, this won't be like when I tried to stream a few days ago. I've got a different window size. So from your end, it won't be stretched either. It's actually running a 16:9 aspect ratio. I'm running in a 1600x900 window.
Returning to course, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you. try to avoid the super shallow water if possible.
Yes, sir. Return into course, sir. Yes, sir.
Alrighty. Another thing to note with American fleet boats, it seems Fall of the Rising Sun has maintained this through the stock game. In the stock game, and I believe it's also true in Fall of the Rising Sun, the most fuel-efficient speed on the surface for a fleet boat is 10 knots. Which, if I go to here, yeah, it is. Nautical miles.
Yes, sir. Current speed, 9.
That's different from when I last did that. Maintain that. Basically, that's one thing I remember from the stock game, is if you roll around at 10 knots, you basically never have to worry about running out of fuel, unless you're trying to make the run, like, from Midway to Japan in a Gato. That's something you have to keep mindful of your fuel. I'm fairly certain that's one of ours. Yeah, it is.
Sonar contact. Warship closing. Bearing.
That reminds me.
Long range.
Turn on our radar. First actual save. Did it again, didn't I? I have the pre-launch save, and I have this save here in the event our game crashes. Alright. Let's control M. Oh yeah, this. All submarines are reminded that you are to remain submerged except to charge your batteries during night hours with poor visibility. Try the game with poor visibility. Whenever within 500 nautical miles of an enemy airbase, you are to use one engine when on the surface to conserve fuel. You are also to husband your torpedoes and only use what is necessary to accomplish the task. So, they're telling us not to alpha strike everything. And that's fair. Thank you. typically I'm actually pretty hesitant about firing a torpedo, because I usually worry about running out. So. Yeah, no worries, game. No worries. PAC news received. I believe this is the China declaring war on Japan. Yeah, China has officially declared war on Japan. Now that is relevant, because China is a faction in this mod. They have some air bases. I don't remember where they are, honestly. But yeah, China does have some air bases. Speaking of which, let me slow down the time compression real quick. Yeah, it's this menu. This is, if you played Silent Hunter 3 with, I think it was GWX, this map may look familiar in a way, if you remember the Allied air map for the Atlantic Theater. So we are most assuredly inside Saigon's bubble. That'll be something to pay attention to. We can also see where the convoy routes are. Oh yeah, I was going to talk about this, if we talk about it now. This island, Truck Island here. For whatever reason, in my stock installs of Silent Hunter 4, this base, this was never a base for Japan. For whatever reason, it thought this was Truck, whenever I go to resupply with the Germans. It would call this Dublin. Or Duplon. Dublin. I'm probably gonna call it Dublin. Duplon? Duplon? Anywho. That's moaning right there. Oh, radio message received. Let's have a look. Got it. Comm sub pack. Message received. Oh yeah, also. On Thursday, December 11th, 1941, Germany and Italy have declared war against the United States. The European and Southeast Asian wars now become a global conflict between the Axis powers of the Japanese Empire, Germany, and Italy, united against the United States, Great Britain, France, and their allies. Also, there's an enemy warship. 124 2 East, 1526 North, 124 2 East, West Northwest 9 knots. That's this guy. Oh, we just got another one. Oh, wait, that was that. Yep, I got it. Oh, I must have entered. Yeah, I entered my patrol grid. What's my current range? Still 12,000. It's gonna become daylight soon, so we're gonna be at risk of enemy aircraft. Saigon is literally right there. We may pay Saigon a visit, actually. Unfortunately, there are no ports inside our circle. I'm gonna maintain the south side of the circle. Submarines are reminded to submerge during daylight and other high visibility hours. Only surface during dark night hours for battery recharge and other maintenance duties. Remember only to use a minimum number of torpedoes needed. Let the Mark VI Exploder do its job. It's gonna take some time. Although, I mean, it in theory worked, they just didn't actually try it. Even though the weapon had been around since the interwar period. Fox traffic. Wrong button. All craft be advised, Japanese invasion of Borneo imminent. Request assistance and aid from patrol craft in the area. I'm north of Borneo. Wait. That's us it was hearing, if you were wondering. Back to it. can't tell what that is. It's to our northwest, though.
Yes, sir. Due course, 3-1-6. Due course, 3-1-6. Due course, 3-1-4. Due course, 3-1-4.
Where is he now? Let's see if we can acquire him.
Zodar, warship moving away. Bearing.
Warship
three,
moving slow,
four,
huh?
Long range.
Is he by himself?
Zodar, merchant closing.
There
bearing.
We go.
3-4-7.
Okay.
Long range.
Seconds, he should be about here. Might be 8 knots, actually. Oh, that looks pretty good. This course looks right. Every 3 minutes and 15 seconds, he'll make 700 yards. We'll make 1,000 in that time period. So, a nautical mile is 2,000 yards. So we can make a mile every 6 minutes. So in an hour, I could be there. And he will have traveled 7,000 yards. He'll be there. That's our intercept course. I'll travel 10,000 yards, which is half that. I'll travel this much. Ooh. Yeah, I would have needed to be going 20 knots in order to make that work. So what's our distance now? 7 miles. So my shooting range for reference. So on the fast setting, I'm 2.5 nautical miles, or 2.25 nautical miles, excuse me. And for my slow speed, 9,000 yards is equivalent to 4.5 nautical miles. So I have a 4.5 nautical mile bubble around my boat, effectively, is my engagement circle. So I can shoot right about to there. Go ahead and go to the bridge. Make a save. I won't be saving that often in the future, but I just want to make sure we get this first. This first contact, make sure nothing wonky happens with the mods and stuff like that. Anywho, I might be able to see him. Perhaps not. Maybe too close to the water. Don't have enough height. So, at current speed, in an hour, I will make 5,000 yards. Or I'll make 10,000. So make 5,000. So in an hour, I'll be here. And he will be... He'll make 7,000 yards in an hour, and he will be there. it's getting to be daylight. Visibility is improving. Let's see if I can get any eyeballs on.
Ship spotted.
Well, since you can see them, where are they?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
036. So you say. Oh, there he is. Okay, so we're to our horizon. That actually might be the escort, actually.
Ship spotted.
Thank you. There's no way they see us yet. Calling that a warship, huh? It's probably an auxiliary merchantman, then. And what do you say the range is? 39,000 feet. So 39,000 feet divided by 3 for yards. He is about 10,000 yards. Actually, no, more like 12. 30,000 is 10,000 yards. Yeah, just about. So again, our shooting bubble is right here. We're not quite there yet. But it looks like I've got their speed now. Let us close a little bit. Why is he maneuvering? Taking any action against us either. Okay, looks like a legitimate course change. Oop, okay, one moment. My cat has decided something.